and gentlemen, we're ready to start. We'd like to invite you to please find your seats. And we need to ask that you keep the aisles free. Keep the aisles free, please. Appreciate that. We want you to know that there will not be an intermission in our program tonight. So just buckle up for the long haul. We also want you to know that there are some concessions that you can purchase out the back, and feel free to go and do that as you please as well. We'd like to welcome you, ladies and gentlemen, to our program this evening. 50 years in the making, we're happy to present to you Home Show 2024.
The first 50 years. No sport develops the level of trust and reliance on others as does acrobatics. 50 years of teamwork. 50 years starts now.
gentlemen, the Akroners. Oh, I tell you, I don't know how many times you have to watch this, but every time it's brand new. What a performance. Let's catch our breath for a moment. The year was 1963, when Dr. Martin Luther King gave the life-challenging address to 250,000 Americans entitled, I Have a Dream. 10 years later, in 1973, Dr. Neville Matthews, then president of CUC, had another dream. He had a dream about having a group of gymnastic acrobats touring as representatives of Canadian Union College, traveling all across Canada, doing acrobatic performances from community to community. He had a dream where he saw the potential of an acrobatic team sharing the story of CUC and attracting interest from both parents and young people to the opportunities a Seventh-day Adventist college in Canada could offer them. The very first performance by the team, the very first, then known as the Olympics, was on a groundbreaking ceremony for the facility we are sitting in today in early September of 1973. Since the beginning of the Olympics in 1973, 8 presidents have continued to share the vision of the mission and ministry of the Olympics and Akroners. And this evening, it is my pleasure to welcome to our stage President Lauren Agri.
Good evening and welcome to Akroners Home Show 2024. As you know, this isn't just any ordinary home show. You came to the 50-year celebration of acrobatic excellence and gymnastic artistry. We are so excited that you could be here tonight at Berman University to witness what has happened year after year, decade after decade. Wonderful gymnastic performances, all wrapped around with the ethos of sharing God's love and serving Him and serving others. And we are more than delighted to have you here. We especially welcome those of you who are alumni of the Akroners and Olympics teams. I know the lights are down, but maybe just the shuffle. Those of you who have been on this Akroners or Olympics team, any of these teams over the last 50 years, would you just stand for one moment? These people represent over 1,000 members in 50 years, and we are so happy that you were able to make it back. We welcome you. We welcome the coaches and the assistant coaches tonight who have come back. We welcome the special guests that we will have performing in the program tonight. But there's one group that is here that I would really like to think about for a moment. 50 years ago, Akroners and the Olympics began. And in their early shows, there were many small children, some older, some teenagers, that sat in the chairs that you're sitting in tonight watching. And they were inspired. The theme tonight is the first 50 years. And many of those children came and are the ones that you saw standing. But there are same age children here tonight that will be awe-inspired for the next 50 years. And they'll be able to tell their grandchildren the stories that the members are telling tonight. So I am so happy there'll be a next generation coming along to carry on the legacy of the Akroners. And if our heavenly homecoming hasn't happened yet, another 50 years will make it triple digits, 100. And that's a time that they'll be able to enjoy themselves. But tonight we're here to enjoy a show. Please sit back and relax. You won't be there for more than a moment or two until you're sitting on the front edge of your chair with bated breath and beating heart watching what's happening tonight. So once again, welcome. We're delighted to have you to 2024 Akron Air Home Show.
Our first coaches, Dustin and Vanessa Dudar, coached the team for 2 years from 2014 to 2016. They enjoyed a fantastic group of talented athletes as well as assistant coaches. Their time was busy, not only coaching, but also having their three kids on the team as well. Some of us know what it's like to travel with their children on the team. There were challenges, but the Dudars were well up to the task. Coach Dustin's claim to fame in 1989 was when he and Acro partner Rob White were invited to attend the United States National Acro Competition. This was the first Canadian team to compete nationally in the United States. The dual team qualified for a medal, but because they were Canadian and they had never had outside participation in the acro sport, they were not allowed to receive their medals. So once the team got home, we provided them with the medal that they so much enjoyed and deserved. Ladies and gentlemen, won't you please welcome coaches Dustin and Vanessa Dudar.
Strength, flexibility, and trust.
Practice, communication, and functional muscle.
Choreographed by Coach Hassan and performed by the Akroneers.
Doubles balancing routine.
All right.
Churches, black churches, different people, same hearses. It's kind of hard to fight with each other, laying down in the ground, six under. At every show, I see my people, they ain't the same, but they're all equal. One love, one God, one family. You're missing every color if you're only seeing black. Change your mind if your heart's unmovable. We ain't that different from each other, from one to another. I look around and see worldwide beautiful. Thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God. Oh, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God. Coast to coast, city to city, reach out your hands if you're with me. Still got some work, but we still got a dream. Every shade, every heart, come together and sing. Oh, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God. You're missing every color. If you're only seeing black and white, tell me how you're gonna change your mind if your heart's unmovable. We ain't that different from each other, from one to another. I look around and see worldwide beautiful. One love, one God, one family.
to change your mind if your heart's on overboard. We ain't that different from each other, from one to another. I look around and see you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the doubles balancing routine. Coach Ron Schaefer coached the team from 1980 through till 2024 with several breaks in between. He's coached for a total of 34 years. Over the 34-year period, you can only imagine the many highlights of his career. Ron toured every year with the team, both within the country and at times internationally, including Kenya, Belize, Nicaragua, Jamaica, and Costa Rica. Actually, the greatest highlight for Ron would be the hundreds and thousands, probably, of people that he's been able to interact with over the years. And with that interaction, knowing that the Akron Airs was a very positive influence in so many of them. Esson Emmons, who served as an assistant coach for 1 year with the team, comes to us from the Lower Mainland in British Columbia. His dad is a profound supporter of the Akron Airs and has on several occasions brought his Deer Lake tumbling team to Berman with an interest in recruiting them for the university here on the hilltop. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome coaches Esson Emmons, representing the new generation of coaches, and Ron Schaefer, representing the geriatric generation of coaches.
We'll get Brian Levitt back later. Esson, if you'll tell us about your father's team, if you would, please.
All right. I don't know what can be said that hasn't already been said. Deer Lake Schools had been running their team for at least the last 30 years. That's where I got my start as a little third grader coming up through that team. That gave me the foundation to come here and be a part of this amazing program. My dad, Esmond Emmons, he's been running the program for the last, pretty much since it started. He was coached by one of our alumni here, Gwen Bader, and he took his 1 year of gymnastics at Fraser Valley and turned that into a 30-year program that has given us many, many acrobats.
Very good. We always need to have fresh new talent coming up. So the Deer Lake team represents a fresh batch of new talent. And then we have our own Junior Akron Air program run by Abby Johnson and her staff. And they're also local talent that we count on. We have quite a few members of our team that were Junior Akron Airs. So these two routines will go back to back. And then following that immediately will be the two sets of coaches that work with the Junior Akron Airs who will put together little routines to inspire their students. So at this time, I'd like to bring up the Deer Lake Falcons and the Junior Akron Airs, followed by Abby and Yovan and Abby and Julianne.
We will fall together. together with our differences. Together we are bolder, braver, stronger.
The Deer Lake Tumbling Team.
This pressure rocks me to my core. All these eyes on me are so stone cold. I'm so scared of what I can't control. Can't control. I wanna feel like I'm strong enough to reach the peak. But this mountain only gets more steep. Yeah, it's already so hard to breathe. Hard to breathe. I'm wasted, thinking that I'm too complacent. Everything's so complicated. I can't take it, I'm fading. I'm trying to find my way before I leave this place. Wondering if I'll be more than a memory. If I go down in flames and I fall from grace, is that all you'll see when you remember me? Till the day that I die. If I'm penniless and working nights, or you see my name in flashing lights, will you be standing by my side? By my side. Whoa. Wanna have no hesitation. Wanna trust the path I'm taking. Maybe I'm just too impatient, but I can't stay here waiting. I'm trying to find my way. I can't keep doubting every step I take. I can't keep worrying, I must be brave. No more holding back, I've gotta learn to let go of the pain. I'm gonna find my way, no matter what it takes. Nothing's stopping me, this is my destiny. I may go down in flames, but I'm not afraid to see the best of me when you remember me.
Ladies and gentlemen, our junior Akronaires. They say if you train them up when they're young, they'll end up like Ron Schaefer when they're old.
Check the tomb all the way through, the grave was empty inside. Ain't no other pool, the greatest miracle of all time. You got power, demons cower when they hear your name call. You got power, the steel towers make a lion look small. You got power to devour any counterfeit roar. Even your tongue is a sword, gallop the score. You are the Lord. Second chance, see all the lifted hands, can't count them.
Performing this evening, I believe the future in acro sport is very secure for our Hilltop. We're looking forward to what the future holds. Coach Rachel New, came to the Akron Air and coached them together with her husband Levi for the years 2011-2012. They had a fantastic year watching the youth achieve high-level skill acrobatics. With four children following along, they did not get much sleep in those days. In spite of that, they led the team on a British Columbia tour that year and had the prestigious opportunity to attend the Acrofest at Andrews University in Berrien Springs, Michigan. Levi and his wife Rachel were assistant coaches with Toby Asante in the year 2010-11, and then head coaches in 2011-12. They were coaches for only a short time, but were able to pack a lot of activity into that time. The most challenging part of coaching for Levi was being a young father of four kids and running a construction company at the same time. Won't you please welcome Coach Rachel New as she introduces the ladies' acrobatic pair.
Are you inspired? Yes, this has been wonderful, wonderful show so far. I have the privilege tonight to introduce the ladies' pair. I got to watch them warm up a little and practice. You're in for a treat. I want to introduce Mauv and Chloe. Mauv is 18 and she's attending the University of British Columbia in the fall. And Chloe is 15, they're both from Ontario. And they practice, I asked them, they practice 24 hours a week. And they're still getting school done. So for all you students out there. Mauv and Chloe have traveled the world. They have brought home medals. They're very proud of their silver they took in the Maya International Acro competition in Portugal. And they hope to return there to compete again for the World Championship in September. But before that, they have to qualify at the Nationals in Ottawa this June. So they're putting in a lot of hard work, and we're going to see the fruits of that hard work tonight. For their first routine. They're gonna do two for you tonight. So this routine is balance and static holds like handstands, and you're prepared to be amazed.
Nothing compares, no worries or cares, regrets and mistakes, their memories made. Who would have known how bittersweet this would taste? Never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the hurts instead. Sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead.
We'll be joining them again a little bit later on in the program. What a wonderful performance that was. It sounds like, wait a minute, sounds like the barber is in the building. I think he's looking for someone to shave. Ron, do you see anybody here, you know, that looks a little scraggy and could have maybe improved a little bit, come to the program tonight? Lauren? You're talking about President Lauren Agri? Well, Lauren, you need to come with Ron here. We need to do something about this. I would be a little embarrassed, I'm sure, if I was you and not having come and properly prepared your facial body part. Have a chair there, Lauren. So glad you're volunteered for this.
E pronto fa tutto la notte e il giorno, sempre di torno in giro sta. È meglio che un cane per un barbiere, vita fenomena non si dà. Raso di pettini, lanciati forti, a mio comando tutto qui sta. Lanciati forti, raso di pettini, a mio comando tutto qui sta. Bella risorsa, pur del mestiere,
e con la donnetta,
col cavaliere,
con la donnetta,
col cavaliere,
di qualità. Tutti mi chiedono, tutti mi vogliono, donne e ragazzi, vecchie fanciulle, e quale parrucca, presto la barba, quale sanguigna, presto mi è, tutti mi chiedono, tutti mi vogliono, tutti mi chiedono, tutti mi vogliono, quale parrucca, presto la barba, presto mi è, Figaro, 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 Figaro. Ahimè, ahimè, che furia, ahimè, che folla una alla volta. Per carità, per carità, per carità. Una alla volta, una alla volta. Per carità. E Figaro? E Figaro,
su qua, Figaro qua, Figaro là, Figaro qua, Figaro su, Figaro giù, Figaro su, Figaro giù, Figaro su. Non è bellissimo, so che viene fuori questo del fatto della città, della città, della città, della città, della città. Bravo Figaro, bravo brevissimo, bravo Figaro, bravo brevissimo, fortunatissimo, 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 per verità. Bravo Figaro, bravo brevissimo, bravo Figaro, bravo brevissimo, tir fatuna, tir fatuna, non mancherò. Sono il fatato della città, sono il fatato della città, della città, della città.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Barber of Seville. performed by Coach Nyron Compton. After our performance this evening, ladies and gentlemen, if you need any facial service, you can contact Coach Nyron Compton. He will help you out. Coach Landon Ritchie founded the Olympics, the forerunner of the Akronaires, in the fall of 1973. He was in Sydney, Australia, touring around the country with Brother Gerald when he got the call for an interview with Dr. Neville Matthews. As a recent graduate from Andrews University, he coached the team in 1973, 4 and 5. Coach Landon has many highlights of his time as coach, taking a troop whose skills were very limited and transforming them into a show-ready performing team was his goal. When he shared the vision of what he expected to do with this group, including circus act types, costuming, spotlights, and music to help interpret the acts, you can see the enthusiasm in the young people as they began to blossom. Coach Landon's highlight was watching this transformation take place and see each team member catch the vision of what they were capable of accomplishing. He gives credit to what he was able to do to his mentor and coach from Andrews University, Coach Robert Kalua. Coach Landon himself performed along with the team many of the acts you'll see here tonight. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the originator, the founding coach of our first touring acrobatic team from CUC, Coach Landon Ritchie.
Is this microphone working? Very good. I asked Ron why he asked me to introduce this next act. And he said, hey, I want you to set it up just the way they set it up when you were doing the block act way back in 1973-74. Any of you folks ever watched that act? Do you remember it in the old gym? Dean Semigrad is here, and he was the last guy that did that act with me, and previous to that was Mike Meharry. But the way Wayne Culmer would set it up, my assistant coach, he would say, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to be extremely quiet as we bring on these two performers. This is a very difficult act. It takes a lot of strength and balance. And if you even whisper in the audience, they could tumble to the ground and die. I had an opportunity to talk to Kenneth Lindemann, who's going to perform this act, and he just happens to, just not long ago, be performing the same act at Circus des Soleils. He was on Broadway. He's currently a coach out in Quebec. And he said, yes, it does take strength, and it does take agility, and it does take balance, but he says, I'd like to have fun as well. So I want you to enjoy the music that goes along with this balancing act. And let's bring on Mr. Ken Lindemann. Give him a big hand all the way from Quebec.
I ain't riding no waves, too busy making my own way. Suffering on my own way, baby. Suffering on my own way, baby. Suffering on my own way. The night is electrical. I've been told y'all this is cinema. I am on my Kubrick horn like a Spielberg. Close to kind of fall. Feeling awesome to be black. And I'm making all competition. Making what I wanna, that's a flex. Can't do what you wanna, ain't that a bitch? Slow up when I want to show gun. Magic, I'm feeling my pumps. Make them go dumb with them hums. Nah, I ain't riding no waves. Too busy making my own waves, baby. I ain't riding no waves. Too busy making my own waves, baby. I ain't riding no waves. Too busy making my own waves, baby. I ain't riding no waves. Too busy making my own waves, baby. Surfing on my own way, baby. Surfing on my own way, baby. Surfing on my own way, baby. Surfing on my own way. The industry so full of shit. Welcome y'all to the enema. Nah, man, no subliminal. Cause they're insecure, they know who they are. Feeling awesome to be black. And I'm working on competition. Everything that I do is a flex. If you don't get me, not my issue, bitch. Slow up, but no one to show gun. Got the magic in my palms. Make them go dumb with them hums. Making my own ways, baby. I ain't riding no waves. Too busy making my own ways, baby. I ain't riding no waves. Too busy making my own ways, baby. I ain't riding no waves. Too busy making my own ways, baby. Surfing on my own way, baby. Surfing on my own way, baby. Surfing on my own way, baby. Surfing on my own way.
Lindemann, hand surfing. Coach Nyron Compton coached the team from 1977 to 1980. While other coaches journeyed around Canada primarily with their teams, some ventured out to countries far and wide. Coach Nyron was always willing to venture out, and one year took his team to the island of Hawaii. What a sacrifice our coaches made for our university. However, adversity struck after an afternoon at the beach in Hawaii when they held a Vespers at one of the local churches. A number of the team members fainted on stage from heat stroke, and others were so burnt they couldn't sit without being in pain. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Coach Nyron Compton.
Hello. Yes, that was very, very interesting trip, I can say. Now, I want to just say something to start with. This previous act before, where I was with Lauren Airgree, I was his dean for a year. And it wasn't payback time, okay? Don't get me wrong. He was a very nice person in the school. But people were wondering about that, if it was that way. This act that you're going to be seeing is probably the one that has been continued on for the past 50 years. It started with the original and carried on, and I carried it on. It is the most, probably the most exciting one that people always would be happy, they would be awing, they would be fantastic with it. And you know what? It all started by jumping on your bed, basically, this is how it all started. So we would like now for you to give a warm welcome to the Akron Airs Vaulting and Mini Trap.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Akronaires with the mini tramp and bolting routine. Coach Stan Detweiler coached the team in 1976-77 and assisted with CUC 14 the summer of 1975. Highlights for the summer would be the tour of the CUC 14 gymnics and performing with the team on stage on a program called On Stage. Stan enjoyed most helping kids learn to develop skills. Well, comedy has always been a part of our program, and sometimes it's intentional, and at other times it's unintentional. One of those unintentional times was at a performance in the Nordegg prison. There was a required outfit change that had to be done between the acts for Ron Schaefer, our coach. It needed to take place very quickly. And as he came flying out on stage to base a butterfly routine, in his professional spread leg stance, looking similar to a gingerbread man, my daughter Trisha, then 5 years old, in a voice loud enough to be heard by several, said, "Coach Ron, your fly is open." The audience, though having seen all, were very gracious to allow Ron to finish the routine. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Coach Stan Detweiler and our only gingerbread man, Coach Ron Schaefer.
Stan was my coach in 1976, and there's one thing that Stan was good at was comedy. Stan, tell us about your old philosopher routine, if you would.
Well, there was, here's one that Kahlua decided to try and work with, and it mimed a guy who talked about things could be kind of going rough and tough, but in the process, you're supposed to lift your head up high and take a walk in the sun with a dignity, a stick-to-itiveness, blah, 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 blah. That's part of the lines. But all these circumstances coming up, but you're still keeping your head up. So within the framework there, it is like an old man. It's like somebody told me today, if you did that routine today, you wouldn't have to adjust your hair, would you? Nope.
So comedy's always been part of acrobatic programs.
It has indeed.
Well, these next two performers, they performed 10 years ago for our 40th anniversary. And if you were here, you may remember that after the show, we were outside watching fireworks, and we had two guys from Cirque du Soleil who had performed, two big guys that did a doubles routine. And as I was on the walkway outside, or not the driveway, they came to me to say goodbye and thank us for being able to be part of the show. But they said, you know that comedy routine that those two guys did? That would be ready to go in any Cirque du Soleil show unedited the way it is right now. Well, if it's that good 10 years ago, and the Cirque du Soleil guys said it was that good, we had to bring him back. And so at this time, we'd like to invite Vaughn Golfin and Levi New for a 10-year encore of their comedy routine.
Levi New and Van Gulfan. It was the second year of touring, and this year it was to Saskatchewan. Coach Landon, who we've introduced before, recalls, the team was to be performing on an afternoon at the city of Yorkton's biggest high school. For the entrance routine, we had torches that each team member would light and march up the onto the stage. All the lights were turned off in the gym. We knew this would be a dynamic impact. The music began as we marched in, wearing red and blue outfits and torches ablaze. We found out that the fire detectors in the Yorkton High School worked very well. All the lights came back on as the fire alarms blared during our opening act. The principal had the crowd evacuated in an orderly manner. Everyone was outside now, the team and the crowd. They said it was Yorkton's first five-alarm fire of the year. The team made quite an impact that year as all of the fire trucks in the city came out to meet us. So Landon, with the fire trucks on standby at CUC in Berman here now, why don't you just tell us about the next routine, the Acro Acrobat?
Thank you, Brian. Thank you for reminding me of that experience from Yorkton with the five-alarm fire. Have you ever wondered what it would be like to take somebody's pole vault, strap three of those pole vaults together with some type of adhesive, and then find two fellows that are 5'11.5" tall, and then some very brave woman that wants to stand on that bar and go through some of these experiences that involve uneven parallel bars, trampoline, and balance beam. It's called the Russian bar. You're going to see that momentarily. Then there's something here called the Roman chair. It sounds like a medieval torture machine, but it's not. As long as the person that is holding up the other person has done their 2,000 sit-ups per day. Because you'll notice that abs are going to be very important. And then we have a chair act. And I don't know why I was thinking of Shelley and Lauren Agri having a nice, quiet Sabbath dinner. And Lauren says to Shelley, you know, that was the most beautiful dinner you've ever made for me, honey. I'd like to do something special for you. So he got all the chairs from around the table and he stacked them up in these really weird shapes, and he crawled up on top of the chairs and said, honey, thank you for that beautiful meal. Would Lauren do something like that? What if he climbed up there and chose to do a handstand or two? You're going to see that very same thing take place here shortly. And then there's another act called the flag. It's not like the Canadian flag. It's just a big tall pole with a flag, but it's a human flag. And then lastly, and I'm waiting to see this, somebody told me, you said to me that somebody may just actually split the blocks tonight. Well, in the history of acrobatics within our church, which goes way back to the early 60s, anybody that could split the blocks and not kill himself was a significant individual. I don't mean he'll kill himself, but you could get injured. So enjoy yourself here, folks, with the Acro Apparatus performers. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Akronaires with their Acro Apparatus. Coach Wayne Colmore led the team as an assistant coach to Coach Richie and MC'd in the years 1973 to 75, and as a coach to the summer CUC 14 summer tour across Canada in 1975. Wayne's unnerving challenges include watching Coach Landon split the blocks just as we saw happen moments ago. As well, heights were not a great part of his life, especially when he was called to be on the top of a two high. Possibly it was because of these unnerving events in Wayne's life that when asked if he had any unforgettable moments as a coach, he simply replied, "Yes, many, but fortunately for me, I have forgotten all of them." As MC, he was also responsible for the spiritual development of the teams and also proposed to remember who we were performing for to God's glory. Won't you please welcome Coach Wayne Colmore.
I don't know about you folks, but I am totally amazed with what we've seen here tonight. Yeah. In fact, my heart has been pounding in my chest, and my back hurts. This next performer, after bidding farewell to the Akronaires, her journey took her on an exhilarating turn toward aerial arts, specifically focusing on the mesmerizing art of aerial skills. This new adventure propelled her onto various prestigious stages, including performances at the Canada Winter Games, venues in the Netherlands, and numerous events across central Alberta. Jody's deep-rooted appreciation for her experience with the Akros remains evident as she now stands as founder of Rise Aerial, a thriving business centered around aerial arts. Grateful for the opportunities her gymnastic background provided, she continues to flourish in her artistic pursuits, reflecting fondly on the path that has shaped her into the passionate performer and entrepreneur she is today. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jody Solomon.
Jody Solomon, ladies and gentlemen. Fantastic. Parents, please have your children not do this at home, especially if they don't have proper music. Another routine that we don't see very often is that of the trampoline. And I understand that Ron Schaefer has been working over the last 34 years to perfect the trampoline. And Ron, did you want to tell us a little bit about that before you fly into it? Where's Ron?
I'm here.
This next routine features a group of people from Red Deer, Thunder Country Trampolines. Ken Sohn is the coach. He's against the wall there. They didn't bring their own trampoline this time, so our old, this trampoline is actually purchased in the 60s. It's an old one. It's the original one that Berman, CUC ever had. The guys are going to do their best to show some incredible skills, but we have four people tonight, four. I won't go through all their credentials, but I know that at least one of them has been to the Olympics. Right, Keegan? Or Kyle? No, that's Keegan. And the others have incredible skills in trampoline. The only limitation today will be the lousy trampoline that we gave them to practice on or perform on. But Ken actually was our assistant coach for 1 year with the Akronairs. The boys have traveled with the Akronairs years ago. You're in for a treat, and hopefully our trampoline will meet the level of skill that they are capable of. Here they are, the Thunder Country trampoline competitors. Do you want to get more light? Need more light? Good, all right.
Ladies and gentlemen, Thunder Country. Powerful. Wow. Coach Scott Schaefer co-coached with Coach Wendy Reese, who joined us on stage in the 1986-87 year. Scott remembers as a 22-year-old college senior feeling challenged. In that, he had to transition from a team member 1 year to head coach the next year. In addition, taking over the reins from Ron, who was Scott's mentor, and who had all the big shoes to fill. While routines like 6+1 give a lot of strength and stamina, the routine Scott remembers most was block of a different color. He writes, "I don't know if it stands out in my mind because the concept of the routine got Ron threatened with a lawsuit from another actor troop, or that the name of my character was Boofer Clarence, or that I was having PTSD over the last time I did a comedy routine on the team as a 15-year-old in a comedy called My Name's Not Stanley. It seemed to go over like a red balloon, and yet..." Ron insisted that it be kept in the show. In spite of it all, Scott managed to have a successful run of Block of a Different Color, and the routine was one he used many times with his team, as well as by other former team members who went out on coaching on their own teams. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Coach Scott Schaefer.
So, in 1980, when I moved here, I was a small child, as evidenced by this jacket, which was big on me. Because I was a small child, I just played with blocks. And I had a cantankerous block that would never do what he was told. I'd stack him up with other blocks and he'd fall out. I'd try to get him to go over there and he wouldn't do what he was supposed to do. And I would cajole him, I would scream at him, I would beg him to hold the stack, and he never would. But finally, this little block has become the master builder, and please welcome Darren Schenkel with his blocks.
Thank you.
And the Blockheads. Nicely done. We had heard earlier a little about Coach Levi and Rachel New and their busy time as a family of four. But one highlight that I never mentioned them doing as coaches was something that they called Eskimo Cheek Wrestling. Now that sounds interesting. And who knows, maybe they'll demonstrate this while they introduce the fire juggling routine. But I suspect we might have to talk to them privately as to the details of that event. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome coaches Levi and Rachel New.
Good evening. So we are here this evening. We're not going to demonstrate Eskimo Cheek Wrestling. But if you want to know, you ask Ron Schaefer, who taught us. But yeah, we're here tonight to introduce the fire juggling routine. We had, back in 2012, we coached and we had a fairly fresh team. Not very many people had come in that were on the previous year. So you, as coaches, you pan your talent and you find out what kind of awesome skills that your team is bringing in from other places. And we discovered we had a young lady on the team that had done baton twirling. And we incorporated, with her willing heart, incorporated it into our home show, and she twirled fire batons. How many of you were here for that show? And you remember it? Not very many. Well, we're gonna see next level fire tonight by our guest performer.
So this next performer, wow, that's loud. He hails from Samoa. He spent many years in Hong Kong, performed for Disney for 15 years. He's been fire juggling for 30 years. He, thank the Lord, became an Adventist and was baptized in 2005. He now resides in Calgary. And ladies and gentlemen, let's turn the heat up a little bit in here. And please welcome Harry Puapua'i'i.
Oh!
Ladies and gentlemen, the Samoan Fire Knife. Wonderful.
I don't know about you guys, but that was really incredible. We like to find all sorts of crazy things as Akronaires to try and do up here for you guys, but that was amazing. So as you can tell, Harry has performed at many championships. He did the annual Fire Knife Championship and won that. He won another one in Anaheim. Absolutely incredible. We're going to give him another minute to, or a few seconds to get ready for the next part. So here we are. All right, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back Harry Poipoli'i.
Samoa Sawia!
Nicely done. Wow. Coach Sheila Van Alstyne March was assistant coach for a 10-year span starting in 1984, with one of those years as head coach. Not only was Sheila involved in the tumbling routines, but her gift of music was impactful for the overall performance. The selection of music for routines was part of it, but also her vocal talent was incorporated into all programs and in church involvement where the team traveled. Sheila would develop synchronized routines that were most unique in that it required a different method of skill used to in order to for everyone to perform as a single unit or in a perfect timing. Sheila was likely part of the Hawaiian Sunburn Gang, as was mentioned earlier, but her take on the trip to Hawaii was to see the positive reaction to the team's performance when local educators suggested they would never hold the attention of the students. The very opposite happened and blew the students and faculty away by their performance. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Coach Sheila Van Alstyne Bartsch.
Well, first of all, I have to say that I've been at a lot of acro shows in this building. And Ron, I don't know if you remember this, but when we were in Hawaii, we went to a school that they told us this crowd would not even, the students wouldn't even stay for the end. And in reality, what ended up happening is not only did they stay for the end, they screamed and yelled so loud for everything that they saw that we were actually writing out on pieces of paper what our instructions were behind the curtains because nobody could hear us. The team had no idea what we were saying. I actually think tonight this crowd is outdoing that. So because these guys are giving it their all, let's see if this crowd outdoes Hawaii on three. Give it all you've got. One, two, three. Yeah, you did it. That's awesome. What Brian was talking about is in 1985-86, I was invited to come down to the Composite High School here in Lacombe and teach Cheer Squad. I had no idea what it was, never heard of it, didn't even know it was a competition. Went down there, watched what they did and went, well, I don't know what I'm doing, but I think we can do better than that. So the school started sending me away to different things, to conferences and stuff, and coaching places to learn how to coach Cheer Squad. What I learned about Cheer Squad is that it becomes very technical. The technique has to be absolutely accurate. It's timed to music. If you miss a stunt, you could get hurt. There'll be nobody there to catch you. You've seen a lot of that type of stunting that's happened here. So I was talking with Coach Toby, who has developed this routine, and she said, well, we're not doing it as precision like it was back when you were coaching it, but we are doing multi-base stunting. It is fast, it is quick, it has to happen accurately. Also, she wants you to know that they're going to do 5 decades of music. So try to find your decade in all of this music. And I have to tell you, I am super excited to see this routine. So ladies and gentlemen, this is the new cheer.
Well, you can tell by the way I use my walk, I'm a woman. ready, young man. When you're short on your dough, you can stay there. And I'm sure you will find many ways to have a good time. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. They have everything fundamental and joy. You can hang out with all the boys. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. You can get yourself clean.
Celebration. Ready, hook. good soldier, choosing your battle. Pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over.
Ready, go.
The pressure's on, you feel it, but you got it all, believe it. When you fall, get up, oh, oh, and if you fall, get up, cause this is Africa.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling.
Ready. Ready, ho.
Ladies and gentlemen, there they are, the Akronaires with the cheer.
All tied up, no more love, and I'd hate to see you waiting.
Well, the show is almost coming to an end. We appreciate the fact that you hung in there with us on this extended version of our show. Home shows tend to be that way, and this one's extra special. Back about 25 years ago, I honored a gentleman who had been one of my inspirations to start in the field of physical education. That was Mr. Gordy MacDonald. And then we honored another gentleman a few years later, and that was Landon Ritchie, who's here tonight with us as the first coach of the gymnastics team here on the Hilltop. But I got thinking, way more important than those two gentlemen in my ability to pursue this career all these years is somebody who brought me into the world. So I'd like to bring my mother up here, Brendan, and Brendan and mother, come on up. Now, we have a picture to go on the screen. My father was also part of this bringing me into the world thing, but he is, he's home. He is not very mobile. He'll be 94 in a couple months, and so he's not here tonight. But my nephews, Brendan, who was on the team for one trip to Belize, and my other nephew, Jaden, who was on the team quite a few years, are going to bring up their grandmother, my mother. So this lady has been instrumental in the success of the Akronaires, not only in producing one of the coaches, but she has cooked countless meals, countless buckets of soup or bowls of soup and cookies, and the list goes on. For how many years, Mother?
50.
All right. So I'd like to, Sheila, if you could bring that out here. I'd like you to give a big hand for Shirley Schaefer, Dave Schaefer on the screen up there. Can we get a picture? Is there somebody who can get us a picture here? Oh, we got a picture down here. No, stay. You come in here. No, stay in here.
It's really heavy. Help.
Okay.
Okay.
down here. There we go.
All right. Help her back to her seat there, okay. All right, Brian, come on up.
Have you been having fun tonight? What a great program, eh? Fantastic. We'd like to just introduce the coaches to you. But I'd like to have the house lights on if I could, because I'd like to have those that trained under the coaches just to stand when they come up here on stage. So first off, beginning our whole crusade with Akroneers and acrobatics and the Olympics and gymnastics and all the rest, Landon Ritchie was our very first coach. He coached the year 1973 and 1974. Landon Ritchie. And I'd like to invite those that trained under Landon to stand, if you would, just for a moment. Yeah, I know it's difficult to get up for some of you. All those were yours, Landon, back in 1973, 40, 74. Perfect. Wayne Callmore, you may be seated, thank you. Wayne Callmore followed in 1974, 75. And I'd like to invite those that trained under Wayne Callmore to, if you would stand as well, right now. Let's see, got some, yes. All right, excellent, good. 1975, 76 was Dr. Cyril Dean. Of course, you know, he has passed away, but I'm wondering if there are those here that trained under Dr. Dean, if you would just stand. Yes, there's some here, a few over here. Great. All right. Then we have Stan Detweiler. Stan Detweiler served under 1976 to 1977. Wondering if we could have those that are, could stand who have trained under this young man right here. Ah, a good number of them again. Some of you are standing several times at one time here. Next, in 1977 and 1980, is Nyron Compton. Nyron, come on out, and we invite those that were training under Nyron to stand up as well. There we got a few younger ones now. That's good. Then in 1986 to 87, we had a co-coaching staff working with the Akroneers, and that was Wendy Reese Weil and Scott Schaefer. If you would come out and join us on this thing, stage here. And we'd like to invite you to stand if you trained under Scott or Wendy, and or Wendy, during that year of 86, 87. There's a few of you out in there. That's good. All right. There's Scott. Good. 1989 to 1990 was Sheila Van Alstyne-Bartsch. Sheila, are you back with us here? And could we ask again, those who trained under Sheila, if you would just stand. Yes. Oh, there's one. Oh, there's some more. Very good. All right. 2010, 2011, Toby Asante was the coach. I'd like to invite you to stand if you trained under Toby Asante. All right. Number of those as well. And then 211, 212, Levi and Rachel New. Come on out, coaches. And could we have those standing that were training when they were the coach? Yes, we have a number of those out here as well. In 2014 to 2016, Dustin and Vanessa Dudar. Could I invite you to stand if you trained with Dustin and Vanessa? Good number of them. Yes, indeed. And then there, in 2016 and 2019, we have Richard Gray, who is not able to be with us tonight. But if you trained under Richard Gray, would you just stand as well, please? Good number of them on that as well. I almost need to sit down myself, because by the time we get announcing the next one, we're all going to be tired. Ron Schaefer. Nineteen 1980 to 1986, 1987 to 1989, 1990 to 2010, 2012 to 2014, 2019 to 2024, and on into infinity. Ladies and gentlemen, Coach Ron Schaefer, if you stood, stand on up here if you've trained with him, or even if you just love the guy. Glad to have it here. Ron Schaefer. 34 years of coaching this team at this university. 34 years. Incredible, Ron. Thank you so much. We'd like to acknowledge and recognize that degree of sacrifice and commitment, and ask Dr. Lauren Agri if he would come up and make a presentation to you on behalf of the university here at Bird.
I want to take a moment to thank each one of you for the impact you've had on our students' lives over the last 50 years. It's been incredible, just as this evening has been, and we thank you so much. Nyren, I just have to say, that was the closest shave I've had in a long time. But I think you missed a spot. So maybe 50 years is a long time. It's long enough for a sapling to grow into a towering giant and reach the sky. It's long enough for a young person to come and commence their studies and graduate and then have a full and fulfilling career up to retirement. It's long enough for the technology that we have to transform the way we live. And it's long enough to educate and train several generations of young people who have a passion for athletics and a passion for God. And that's what Akron Airs has been all about. And I want to thank each one of you on behalf of Berman University for making a difference. And Ron, I'm going to ask you to come forward, and I'd like to present to you a plaque, and through you to the rest of the coaches. This plaque says, in recognition of exemplary athletic and gymnastic performance and local and global service to God and others, Berman University congratulates the Akron Airs on 50 years of excellence. Thank you so much.
And Ron, we're not finished with you yet. So if you'd like to just come back out here. Toby, would you come up, please?
Yeah, we'd like to thank you, Coach, for everything that you've given to this team, to keeping the sport alive for as long as you have. Just be willing to sacrifice everything, even your health sometimes. just thank you for being such a great example to us all these years.
I've had the privilege of working with Ron for many years, and I wasn't going to do this, so I'm still not going to do it. he has been a mentor and an inspiration to me, and I know to many, many of you. And so we just want to thank you for all the time that you put into the lives of each and every one of these individuals. Okay. but thank you, Ron. It means the world to many, many, many people. And I'd want to thank the team for their contributions and very generous alumni contributions. We put together a nice little gift for Ron, and I think he will enjoy many parts of it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Coach Ron Schaefer.
It's been a great evening, and we've just got one or two numbers left. But thanks to, well, I was coached by the first three. I was tolerated by some of the others. Most, all from here down, from Hugh down, I think everybody was also a student of mine, except for Wendy. Wendy wasn't, she was a colleague. But it's been a great evening. I want to thank Larry Murin on the sound. If I thank too many people, I'll forget some. But Larry Murin, there's few people that sacrifice his time like Larry Murin does. Incredible. And of course, Toby and Asan for assistant coaching this year. The Deer Lake team for coming all the way out. And of course, Abby with her crew did a great job. This program's going a bit long, but just bear with us. We're almost done. You saw in our booklet that we have some projects we're working on to complete the Acro Center, get some more equipment, etc. A very generous person came by today and said, tell the people tonight that I will match dollar for dollar up to $24,000 what we can collect tonight. If you would like to, there's envelopes on your chairs. If you would like to contribute to some capital projects for the Akronaires to finish up our Acro Center and some other equipment we need, if you give $5, we get $5 from this very generous donor, we could get $48,000 tonight. Wouldn't that be cool? Wouldn't that be cool? We could buy another trampoline that we could take without having to bring out this junk. All right, so once again, and Brian Levitt, always can count on Brian Levitt for MSC. He's been doing this for about 10 or 12 years. Thanks very much. I think that was what all I had to say, so we'd like to bring on now our final, who's introducing this one, Brian?
Right behind you.
Toby, all right. And we want to thank so much the guest artists. Weren't some of those routines incredible? Absolutely. All right.
Toby Asante coached the team on and off since 2000 and was a head coach in 2010-11. Unlike other tours of the team, Toby held local mystery tours around Central Alberta. The team never knew each day where they were going or what they would be doing. Clues were given throughout the day to keep the suspense going. Toby will be remembered through time as the only coach to have borrowed the Alberta Conference bus on a wintry day, hit black ice while in Calgary, rode off the bus. Her words, "brace for impact," will ever be embedded in her memory. Fortunately, no one was injured, and with only a few hours delay while new rentals were acquired, all was well. Although Toby desired to have a simple home show, the team convinced her to have a themed program of the Lion King, with full backdrop, staging, uniforms, music, and routine overall, all in a three-week period before home show. Likely, this was one of the first home shows with a full theme and a storyline. It came off with no noticeable hitches. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Coach Toby Asante.
Well, thank you. I have I've been part of this team for just a little bit, and I've loved every moment of it. One of my bucket lists was to put together a doubles routine. I had that chance actually just about 15 years ago, and I can attest it's a lot of hard work. And Akronaires actually produced, I guess, the first Canadian ladies pair that traveled down to the States. They competed in 1996 in Palm Springs. This was Kaylee and Angie, and they represented Canada and CUC very well in the U.S. Nationals, and they placed second in their category. So we come from a very good background of doubles routines. So I would like to invite Chloe and Maeve back for their second routine. This routine is a combination routine. It combines balance and strength with dynamic and tempo moves. And I'd like to introduce Chloe and Maeve.
Thank you. so tired. Why can't we speak at night? Translucent minds.
Ladies and gentlemen, Chloe and Mauve, the ladies acrobatic pair. Wow, beautiful. As we mentioned previously, music plays an integral part in the development of the acro program. In each program, we would close with a time of reflection and meditation. I'd like to invite once again Coach Wayne Colmar to come and introduce our ladies' vocal duet.
This weekend, I got a clear sense of what heaven will be like. Getting reacquainted with so many awesome people that I have been blessed to know. I can imagine in heaven a call going out for all Olympics, CUC14 and Akron Airs to a special meeting with Jesus in his house. And my prayer is that we will all be there. Soon we'll come to the end of life's journey and perhaps never meet anymore. Till we gather in heaven's bright city, far away on that beautiful shore. If we never meet again this side of heaven, as we struggle through this world and its strife, there's another meeting place somewhere in heaven, by the side of the river of life, where the charming roses bloom forever, and where separations come no more. If we never meet again this side of heaven, I will meet you on that beautiful shore. Please welcome to the stage a vocal duet by former coach Sheila Van Alstyne-Bartsch and Sharon Pochka Mason.
Places I remember all my life, though some have changed, some forever, not for better, some are lost, and some remain. All these places have their moments, with people and friends. Still recall some are dead and some are living. But in my life, I've loved them all. But of all these friends and loved ones, there is no one with you, and as memories lose their meaning, when I think of love as something new, though I know I'll never lose affection for people and friends that went before, I know I'll never stop and think about them. In my life, I've loved you more. heaven, this side of heaven. I will meet you on that beautiful shore.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, you have been the greatest audiences, and we thank you for joining us this evening. We've attempted tonight to give you a taste of 50 years of Berman's history as it pertains to gymnastics and their mission. And as always been, we are pleased to bring to you our grand finale. Ladies and gentlemen, for one last time, won't you welcome the entire troupe of Akronaires as they present to you their grand finale.
Just before, Brian, we need to make two more acknowledgements. We've had some incredible help this weekend. If it wasn't for Alan Hodgins, who acted as our stage manager, it would have been tough. Thank you, Alan. And where's Darren? Where's Darren at? Where's Darren? Now, Darren is not 20 years old anymore. And he was flipping through the air, did a nosedive off the trampoline, was off the stage, was not planned, quickly went back with paramedic Alan, patched him up, came back and finished the routine. So thank you, Darren, for 52 years old and up here doing this kind of thing. If you had made a donation in your envelope and could give it to either Larry at the table over there or Brian or myself or Toby, we'd be so grateful for that. And hopefully we will match those donations tonight and end up with $48,000. Wouldn't that be cool, team? All right. Once again, thank you all for coming. And Toby, introduce the team to us.
All right, first we have Kenny. He's from British Columbia, and this is his first semester on the team. Then we have Mateo. He is a multi-sport athlete, but loves volleyball, and he's my son. Then we have Caleb C. He's really enjoys photography and is an avid outdoor enthusiast. Aaron is Korean, and he loves tumbling. Prince is a BC boy, and he likes mangoes. Kiriana is a sailing skipper and is the mightiest man on Akronaires. Nathan loves disc golf and right-hand drive cars. Kim can speak three languages and is from Argentina. Logan loves biology and he has a bachelor's degree. Trin teaches junior acros and was born and raised in Lacombe. Jay is the other Korean, and he says, one day I'm going to be stronger than Coach Schaefer. Abby is always in the mood for ice cream and loves soccer. Abby really enjoys snowboarding and loves competing with Coach Schaefer. Christine is an education major who loves to travel and crochet. David loves to create art, and he's a third-year accounting major. Becky loves to do handstands, and she has three siblings on the team this year. Jovan, he is a big extrovert, and he's from Texas. Yeehaw! Georgia says, I really enjoy jumping on the trampoline and graduating in June. Seth is from Nova Scotia and likes to go to the gym. Richmond is a track and field athlete, and his best event is the 200 meter. Caleb is going to be an elementary school teacher and is getting married in July. Sarah teaches aerial silks and likes poutines. Ian really likes to do backflips. And he attends PAA. Gabe says, I'm a Filipino, and it's his first year on the team. Bella is the youngest member of the Akronaires and says that one day she wants to coach the team. Sajan is from BC and loves all sports. Kylie loves to dance and teach choreography.
Kiera went to school in North Dakota and likes strawberries and sour cream. Jaina is a wellness major at Berman and loves the outdoors. And Sarai loves math and mixing music for the ACRA routines. And there they are, the ACRANAIR team.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, once again, for our 50th anniversary home show, there they are, the ACRANAIRS. Brian, introduce the rest to us.
And we'd like to also welcome and thank once again our special guests that have joined us this evening, beginning with the ladies acrobatic pair, Chloe and Mauve. Our hand surfing expert, Kenneth Lindemann. The Rise Aerial Silks, Jody Solomon. Our trampoline expert, Thunder Country Trampoline. Our Samoan knife, fire knife, the fire juggling, Harry Pupuali. We'd also like to thank and enjoy us here, Deer Lake School. Come on up, Deer Lake. And following up with them, the Junior ACRANAIRS. Run up there, gang.
Go fast, go fast.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's the whole crew.
Okay, up to the towers, ACRANAIRS, up to the towers. As they're going to the towers, let me remind you, we have a wonderful display of pictures and memorabilia in the second floor of the PE Center, put together by Kylie and her crew. Please go visit that after and enjoy some of the history of the ACRANAIRS. This next part here will have a loud bang to it, so be careful if you have sensitive ears. But once again, our 2024 50th anniversary home show, there they are, our guests and the ACRANAIRS. Have a good night, ACRANAIRS.
Thank you for joining us, ladies and gentlemen, and that brings us to the close of our program.
All right, have a good night, ACRANAIRS. Folks, go down there and say hello to the crowd. Have a good night. Go down there and shake hands.